What can alcohol dependence do to you? Alcohol dependency is pretty complicated. There's short-term and long-term complications. Over the short term, it can impair a person's quality of life, meaning that they can miss school, work, there can be irritability, changes in their mood, breakdown in their relationships with other people around them, deteriorating grades, deteriorating performance. That's just in the short term. Over several months of prolonged and excessive alcohol use, a person can have medical consequences, and this can be agitation, irritability, tremors, difficulties concentrating, and anxiety. Further down the road now, over the longer term, there can be problems on the liver. This can cause hepatitis, not the viral form of hepatitis, but inflammation of the liver caused by the alcohol. So that's one form. Over long term, once the liver, if it keeps getting assaulted by the alcohol, if there's repeated, i.e. if there's repeated episodes of alcohol-induced hepatitis, this can cause scarring, and this is otherwise known as cirrhosis and failure of the liver. In this situation, there's many complications of that. It can affect other parts of the body. Liver failure can cause problems with a person's intellect and their mind, the way they think. They can, over long term, can develop something called what is formerly known as wet brain syndrome, which is actually known as alcoholic encephalopathy. So this is a slow deterioration of brain function because of chronic alcohol use. The alcohol over long term can also affect the person's ability to clot, and so they can excessively bleed and bruise. And then the worst case scenario, they can have bleeding from what's called varices, which are near the esophagus. So this is like a hemorrhoid, but one that's near the esophagus, and if these rupture, it is very close to calling it game over. Nowadays, a lot of times, people who are identified as alcoholics can have scopes done, endoscopes, where they check for these varices, and they can band them, or they can block them from growing any larger and reduce the risk of them rupturing. But in the olden days, a lot of people died from bleeding out by esophageal varices rupture. So there's also a whole host of changes that occur on the skin as well. I guess the best way to summarize it though is long-term problems are pretty dire and can worsen and can be life-threatening, but it does take a long time for somebody to get to that stage. There's a lot more opportunity before then, a lot of time for a person to get some help. It's never too late to get help and to recover from the long-term effects of the alcohol. So to summarize it, the symptoms of alcohol dependency can vary in the short term from interference and consequences in a person's life and performance. Later on, it can cause withdrawal syndromes, things like agitation, tremors, delirium, hallucinations, even seizure. And then over the longer term, with prolonged and sustained use of alcohol, the major consequences are liver failure, hepatitis, cirrhosis, brain problems, i.e. encephalopathy, clotting problems, and esophageal varices.